Right, these are mixture problems, and with mixtures, what you're doing is taking some concentration of liquid, like a 20%, mixing it with another one, like a 50%, to get something in between. So if you mix a 20 with a 50, you could get a 25 or a 30 or a 40, depending on the volume of each type that you're mixing. All right, the other thing you want to look at is if you have 3 liters of something and you mix it with 4 liters of something, you're going to end up with 7 liters, because if you take that 3 liter and that 4 liter and you pour them into the same bowl, there's now a volume of 7. So that's the main principle. This one plus this one will equal this one. Let's try one. So, how many liters of a 14% alcohol solution must be mixed with 20 liters of a 50% solution to get a 30% solution? Now, the problem itself sounds confusing, but once you draw pictures, it's really not that bad. It says how many liters of a 14%. So we don't know how much of the 14% we're mixing. And it says it must be mixed with 20 liters of a 50% to obtain a 30%. Okay, so the one thing we're missing is this volume here, and it's that same principle. This one plus this one equals this one. So if that's x, that's 20, that's x plus 20. And that's all we need. So now we just have to compare the amount of alcohol in each. So if we have a 14% with a volume of x, that gives us 14x. Plus 50% with a volume of 20, that gives us 50 times 20. And that must equal the resulting amount, which is 30% of x plus 20. And you get this. Notice we're just multiplying each time, because that's all you do with percents. Now, you're supposed to change percents to decimals, but since they're all percentages, we don't have to change them. We have a nice clean comparison, which will give us a true equation. So simplify. That's 10, and then two more zeros. And then it would distribute. And that's 6 with 2 zeros. And there's your equation. So I'm going to bring the 14x over. That's 400 equals 16x divided by the 16. So x equals 25. And what does that x represent? It's wherever we placed it. So it's the amount of 14%. So we have 25 liters of 14%. That's it. Now, how do we know where it's correct? Well, we got to do a little check. So we do 14 times the 25 plus 50 times the 20, and that should give us 30 times, well, what is 14 plus, or sorry, 25 plus 20? That's 45. And we just plug it in the calculator. So 14 times 25 plus 50 times 20. And that gives us 1350. And then 30 times 45 is 1350. Checks out. So there you go. These are mixture problems, and they're all set up the same. You just have to fill them in. There's just going to be a missing blank somewhere. Let's try another one. So on this one, it says how much pure dye. So we don't know that amount. And anytime you see the word pure, you want to put 100%, because you've always heard that phrase, 100% pure. Well, there you go. And then we're going to mix it with 4 gallons of a 25% to obtain a 40%. And the same exact rule applies. This one plus this one equals that one. So now we multiply, multiply, and multiply. So it's 100x. Plus 25 times 4 equals 40 times x plus 4. And that's our setup. So if you solve it, you get 1 liter of pure dye. That's how much should be made. But we still need to check it. So we do 100 times 1. Plus 25 times 4 plus equals, sorry, 40 times 1 plus 4, which is 5. So that's 100 plus 100 equals 40 times 5, which is 200, and it checks out. And there you go. That's the main idea. And this works the same with with dollars, if you're still mixing anything, it's the same setup. So just to show you one with money. So we have soybeans, these, and we're mixing in with the wheat to get a mixture of the two. So if you read it, a Miller mix combines soybeans that cost $8.50 with wheat that costs $4.50. How many bushels of each? So that's X to make 800 bushels at $5.50. So anytime we're given the final total, just like when we were doing interest problems, right there, you're given a total of 4,000. You make one X, one what's left. So on here, if we have 800, that's X. That's 800 minus X, same exact way. And then we multiply. Solve the equation, and that gives us 200. And what are we talking about? Bushels. So that means we have 200 bushels of whatever the X is, which is soybean. And what's left is the 600 bushels of wheat. And again, now we just have to check it. And there you go. Checks out. All right. So here are two problems for you to try. See if you can figure them out. If you need to look at the problems before, all the solutions should be there for you. Hit pause and give them a shot. All right, so if you need a little help, here's the setup. We had 7, 4, and 5. That's the resulting mixture. 300. So if they're given the total, then we make 1x, 1 300 minus x. Now see if you can figure it out from here. All right, and this is what you should have gotten. Let's check. And there it is. Completely checked out. All right, one last problem to try. Hit pause. And this is what you should have for your answer. There it all is, and it completely checks out. Thank you.